Intel 8259. This IC is called as the Programmable Interrupt Controller. The purpose of this Programmable Interrupt Controller is to expand the interrupts of 8085 microprocessor. We already know that Intel 8085 microprocessor has got 5 hardware interrupts. In some applications where the 5 hardware interrupt pins are not sufficient, the interrupt pins can be expanded by connecting this 8259 IC. This IC supports 8 interrupt requests. It allows the interrupt request one by one to the processor through INTR pin. This IC can be connected in cascaded mode in a system to expand the interrupts up to 64. In 8085 processor based system, it vectors the interrupt request anywhere in the memory map. The interrupt vector address is programmable. Now, let us take a quick look into the pin diagram of this 8259 IC. This IC has got a D0 to D7 pin, which are the bidirectional data lines. And then there is one pin called as A0 through which we can access the internal address of this IC. Then we have the read and write complement pins, which are used by the processor to either read or write some contents onto 8259 IC. Then we have the chip select pin, which is an active low pin. It is used to select one particular IC when the programmable interrupt controller is operated in master slave mode. Next, we have a pin called as INT. INT stands for interrupt. This is an output pin which is present in the IC. So any interrupt request which is reaching the 8259 will be sent to the processor through this pin INT. Next, we have INTA, which is the input pin of this IC. It is called as the interrupt acknowledge input. When Intel 8259 is serving an interrupt, the service request will send to the 8085 microprocessor. The microprocessor in turn will send an acknowledgement signal which will be reaching the Intel 8259 IC through INTA pin. Next, we have the interrupt request pin, which range from IR0 to IR7. Totally, there are 8 pins, meaning I can connect 8 interrupting devices to this 8259 IC. Next, we have the SP/EN pin. Both these pins are active low pins. SP stands for slave program and EN stands for enable buffer. This SP pin, the slave program pin, is used when this IC is used in master-slave configuration. What is master-slave configuration? In some applications, there may be a requirement where we have to connect more number of interrupts to 8085. So in that cases, I'll be using more than one number of Intel 8259 IC to service that interrupts. In that case, the master device will be connected to, in that case, the master device SP pin will be tied to active high and the slave device's SP pin will be connected to ground. So indicating that one IC is acting as master and the remaining ICs are serving as slave devices. Next, talking about the EN pin. EN pin is called as the enable buffer pin. This enable buffer pin is actually an output pin which will be triggering the tri-state buffers. If 8085 is connected to Intel 8259 in buffered mode, there are two modes of operation. If you are using Intel 8259, I can interface Intel 8259 with 8085 microprocessor in two configurations, namely buffered mode and non-buffered mode. If I am using the system in buffered mode, the tri-state buffer between the 8085 microprocessor and 8259 controller has to be enabled to facilitate data transfer. This is done with the help of ENPIN. It is called as enable buffer pin. Next, we will discuss about the interfacing concept of 8259 with 8085 microprocessor. In this picture, you can see the interfacing circuit between the Intel 8085 and Intel 8259 IC. The address pin, the A0 internal address pin of 8259 is connected to the lower order address pins of 8085. We already know that the lower order address pins AD0 to AD7 are multiplexed to read the address and data line separately. We are using an 8-bit latch. The output of this latch will have the lower bit address of 8085 processor, and the direct line which is coming from the processor will be representing the data lines which range from D0 to D7. To enable this 8-bit latch, the ALE pin of 8085 is connected to the enable signal of the 8-bit latch. The data pins D0 to D7 of Intel 8259 is connected to D0 to D7 pins of 8085 microprocessor. Then the read pins and write pins of 8085 is connected to read pins and write pins of 8259. The INTA pin of 8085, which is the output pin of processor, is connected to INTA complement, which is the input pin of 8259. The INT pin, the interrupt pin of 8259, which is the output pin of this IC, is connected to INTR pin of the microprocessor, which is the input pin, which is the hardware input pin of 8085. The next step which has to be done is interfacing the chip select pin with 8085. The chip select pin can be interfaced with 8085 using two modes. The interfacing can happen either using I/O mapped mode or memory mapped mode. In this example, the mapping between 8085 and the chip select pin of 8259 is done with the help of I/O mapped mode. The address lines, namely A4, A5, A6 and A7, are connected to the inputs of 328 decoder IC. The IC which you see here is a 328 decoder IC. The input pins A, B, C are connected to the address ports A4, A5 and A6 respectively. Then the gate enable pins, the enable pins of this IC are G2A, G2B. These are active low pins. They are connected to the A7 pin. And the G1 pin is the enable pin of this IC, which is connected to the IO/M complement pin of the processor. This right now we are connecting in IO mapped mode. So the IO signal which is coming from the 8085 processor will be connected to the G1 pin. G1 pin is an active high pin. With this, we come to an end of interfacing 8259 with Intel 8085 microprocessor.